Hello students, this video is intended for those who had not attended the Zoom class or those who could not see the video online class properly because of internet connection. So today we had solved exercise 10, question number 8. The figure is given here. As you can see, there are two parallel lines AB and CD, and it is cut by a third line T, which is the transversal. This has made 4 plus 4, 8 angles 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In the question, it is given that angle 1 is equal to 70 degrees. So we are going to find the remaining angles. So let's start. First of all, we will write what is given in the question. Given AB is parallel to CD and T is a transversal. So moreover, angle 1 is equal to 70 degrees. So we are to find the remaining angles. So we know that these two angles, angle 1 and angle 2, angle 1 plus angle 2 will give you 180 degree because it's a linear pair, right? A linear pair is that pair of angle which forms a straight line. So you can see angle 1 and angle 2 are on the same straight line. So angle 1 is 70 degree and angle 2 will be 180 minus 70 degree, that is equal to 110 degree. Now as we have got this 110, we can use vertically opposite angle to find the other angles. If one is 70, 3 is vertically opposite angle, and so it will be 70. Now angle 3, I have to overwrite it. Angle 3 is equal to angle 1, and as angle 1 was 70, we'll write here 70 degree. This is vertically opposite angle, and likewise angle 4 and angle 2 are equal. Angle 4 equal to angle 2. Angle 2, as we have already calculated, here is 110, so this is also vertically opposite angles. Now we have already said here AB and CD are parallel and T is transversal. So in our previous class we had learned that angle 1 and angle 5 are corresponding angle, they look alike, and angle 1 and angle 7 are alternate angles. So angle 5 will be equal to also angle 5 will be equal to angle 1, that is 70 degree. These are corresponding angles, and corresponding angles are always equal. Then you have angle 7 equal to angle 1, that is 70 degree. These are alternate angles. In the similar fashion, angle 2 will be equal to angle 6. These look alike, so these are corresponding angles, and 2 and 8 are alternate angles. So angle 2 equal to angle 6, 100, I have made a mistake here, this should be angle 6. Angle 6 is equal to angle 2. Let me just rewrite it down here. Angle 6 equal to angle 2, 110 degree, corresponding angles, and angle 8 is equal to angle 2, this is also 110 degree. These are just opposite of each other, you can see. So these are alternate angles. In this way we have found all the angles. So angle 1 is equal to angle 3 equal to angle 1, 3, 5, 7. These are all equal and they are 70 degree each. And angle 2, angle 4, angle 6 and angle 8, they are 110 degree each, the white one, as we have already found here. So this is your solution. Hope you understand this. After this, we will move to question number 9. In question number 9, we have to prove that the lines M and N are parallel, and we are given that this angle, angle number 1, is angle 1 is 60 degree, and angle this one 6 is 120 degree, and we are to prove that M is parallel to, and so proof. Here, as we have done in the previous question, we know that angle 1 plus angle 2 is 180 degree. That's a linear pair. So angle 1 was given as 60 degree. So angle 2 is to be calculated. So we know angle 2 will be equal to 180 degree minus 60 degree. Angle 2 is 120 degree. Now, angle 2 and angle 6 are 120 degree each. What does this mean? And these are corresponding angles. So if two angles are equal and they are corresponding to each other, it means that the two lines are parallel. If the two lines are not parallel, the corresponding angles cannot be equal. So I got here 120 degree, this is also 120 degree, and these two are corresponding angles. This means that these two lines are parallel. So proved. That's all. These are the two questions solved in today's class. If you have any doubt, feel free to ask me. Let that be all. Thank you.